welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm in my bathroom, so if it sounds really echoey and awful, I'm so sorry. But I got a request on my first video to do a skincare routine, so that's what I'm doing today. Yay! Okay. So usually the first thing that I do when I do my skincare, before I start, I have oily skin typically. I do have a couple of dry spots occasionally, but for the most part, I would say that I have oily skin, which is disgusting and I hate it. So I try and prevent the oils from appearing on my skin. So to clean my face, I use the Bior Deep Clean Charcoal Cleanser and I just wet my face a little bit before I start. So I'm gonna pump about this much into my hand, and then I'm going to just put this on my face and rub it around in circular motions until it gets foamy and it feels like it's cleaning. So this is how you want it to look like when it's on your skin. Just really get in there. Put my hands a little bit more and go back in. If you feel a slight burning, that's okay. It's just the charcoal taking the soles of your dirt that's in your pores and
fucking killing them.
And then I dampen my rag and I'm just going to wipe away all the product that I put on the face because obviously we don't want to keep that there all day. Okay, after I have successfully cleaned away all the product that I used, what the fuck? I am going to exfoliate my face. I exfoliate my face maybe 3 times a week, depending on how much my skin actually needs it. If you have good skincare, your base makeup, so like your primer, your foundation, your concealer, your powders, that's all gonna go on much, much smoother if you have a good, clean, smooth base. So I really recommend the Freeman Charcoal Sugar Scrub. It's great. Let me just show you. Hell yeah. You really don't need a whole lot because look at this. A little goes a long way. So I'm just gonna take this in my hands. I am gonna get it just a little bit wet because it is pretty abrasive. And then I'm just going to rub this in circular motions on my face just like I did the cleanser. You're really gonna want to focus this where you feel like you have dead dry skin the most. Like I said, I typically have oilier skin, so I don't have to do this all the time, but just exfoliate your face as needed. You know your face better than anyone else. I like to rinse this off with warm water just because the sugar kind of melts off and it's way easier to get off your face. Okay, so after you have exfoliated your face and you feel it and it is super smooth, I like to dry my face and then depending on the day of the week, I will use a mask of some sort. I have a plethora of face masks that I use, so it's a little hard to pick. I just kind of go based off of how my skin looks that day, whether or not I want to do something like, this is what I'm gonna be using today. The Formula 10.0.6, draw it all out. Skin detoxing peel mask, charcoal, and plum. I'm going to use this on my face today just to draw out any impurities that I have in my face, any dirt that's still stuck in my pores, and how long do I leave this on for? 10 to 15 minutes. Okay, so now I'm going to apply the skin detoxing peel mask. Ooh, ASMR who? Maybe that'll be my next video. Okay, so I'm just going to use this brush. I never put on masks with my hands. It's just messy and I don't like it, so I just use a brush because it's easier that way. And I'm gonna take this out and put it on my face. You don't wanna put like a super thick amount of peel mask on just because it'll take 1,000 years to dry, but you know, a pretty decent amount, I would say. Enough to be able to peel it up. Also thin enough that it's going to dry within the time span that it says on the bottle. Okay. okay, now I successfully look, you know, black and charred, just like the people of King's Landing. Okay, so now we wait 10 to 15 minutes. I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. It has been about 15 minutes, and this is ready to go. You guys want some peel corn? That was 100% my hair. Gross. So usually with peel masks, there will be residue. So you just gotta clean that off with your damp rag and it'll come off just fine. Okay, so after I have cleansed my face with the charcoal cleanser, exfoliated with the charcoal sugar scrub, and used the charcoal mat. Wow, I really like charcoal. I don't do this every single time I do my skincare routine, but I go in with the Lush Ultra Bland Face Cleanser just because this stuff literally leaves my skin so soft. It does have beeswax in it, so it's a little hard to fully get off your face just because, you know, wax. I'm gonna take a little bit on my nail like Jeffree Star. And, oh god, that's fucking gross. Why does he do that? Okay, so I'm just gonna take this, and just like I would any normal cleanser, rub it around my face in circular motions. If you can, you typically want to do circular motions up your face and not down, because that just causes your skin to sag sooner rather than later when you age. It's not good for aging at all. Causes wrinkles, and it's just not good to do. So be gentle with your skin. Love your skin. I try and use really hot water when I take off this cleanser just because it does have beeswax in it. Okay, so after I have successfully washed away all the beeswax, I dry my face. You want to use tapping motions whenever you dry your face. You don't want to like freaking scrub your face like that. Just because, you know, there's no lubrication. Not like water is really a lubricant, but you want to be gentle with your skin. God, I want muffins. I'm really craving muffins right now. You guys ever get just like super really weird cravings? Okay, so the next thing I do after I have done the charcoal face cleanser, the charcoal sugar scrub, the charcoal detoxifying mask, and the ultra bland face cleanser. Yes, two face cleansers in one skincare routine. I'm fucking crazy. I typically go in with the Lush Tea Tree Water Toner and then just spray it all over my dang face. I'm gonna pat that in, dry just a little bit. And then for moisturizer, I have been using the Ole Henriksen Counterbalance Oil Control Hydrator. This stuff is actually really good, but the very nice lady recommended me this. It has mint extract in it, so it is very refreshing. It does kind of burn just a little bit because of that mint extract, but like I don't hate it, and leaves a mattifying effect on your skin for up to 8 hours, but it's also hydrating. So I'm going to take just a few pumps of this into my hand, like so, and then I'm gonna rub this all over my face. And that's it. That's quite literally all I do for my skincare routine. But yeah, I mean, that's it. That's my skincare routine. I hope you liked it. I just want to take a second real quick to thank you guys so much for giving so much love and support on my first video. I was really, really nervous to upload it just because I didn't want it to seem cringy or just not good. I know that typically first videos for YouTubers are not good. But I was really happy when I like shared it on my Facebook, and then I looked at it this morning and it has 300 views and I'm like, oh my god, that's like a lot of views for someone who's literally never uploaded a video before. And then 41 subscribers. Hello, my 41 subscribers. This is just really cool, and it makes me really happy to be able to do this. I've been wanting to do this for quite some time, but I was always really afraid to do it, mainly because I didn't have the proper equipment, I couldn't edit videos, and I didn't want it to be really long and drawn out. And also, thank you, Judd, for editing my videos until I hopefully one day learn how to do it. I just appreciate everyone that's giving me the support and everyone who's helping me make these videos. So thank you guys, and I hope you liked the skincare routine. If you guys enjoyed it, leave a comment down below. Subscribe. If you subscribe, you get perfect skin. Anyway, bye guys.